You're listening to Small Biz Matters with Alexi Boyd, and I'm very pleased to be welcoming Kendra Banks, who is the current MD for Seek Australia and New Zealand. And she gave us an interesting chat all about, I guess, the shortfall in female representation in the tech industry. You at Seek are working very hard to try and find that balance. Thinking about small business, though, we still have a lot of gender inequality when it comes to the tech side of things. What sort of top tips would you give to tech companies to try and find those ideal candidates in the tech space?
Well, interestingly, I was just speaking to a small business owner in the summit, and she was saying she's finding it very difficult to attract IT candidates who are female. And all I could say really is you and everyone else, because unfortunately the talent pool is still quite male dominated, and that's true for big businesses, medium size, small size, government, not-for-profit. Anyone trying to hire tech roles is facing this challenge. What we find in general for small businesses and who are trying to fill these really hard to fill roles like IT is that the more they can play up the value proposition of what makes them unique as an employer. So working for a smaller business, you'll have more opportunity to understand how the business works outside of just the tech aspects of the business. You'll be given more responsibility earlier. You will be faced with challenges that in a large organization you might not be. So I think there's a lot of general benefits about working in small business that equally apply to technology and can be really compelling for women in that field who are looking to grow and to make their mark.
And that's a generalised really good tip from someone at Seek, who's obviously the experts in recruitments. We're talking about competing with big business. Are you working with regulation or government or educational facilities at all to try and encourage more women into tech and therefore into roles that are higher up in the leadership?
Absolutely. So at Seek, because of the number one position we have in the Australia and New Zealand markets, we have a really good insight into what talent's available in the market and where there's shortfalls. And we're regularly talking to government at federal, state, and local levels around where those shortfalls are. And tech talent in general is a challenge in Australia and New Zealand, and women and diversity in tech is even more critical. So we're often talking to universities about how they can attract a more diverse student pool to drive that talent pool to a more diverse direction moving forward.
Is it just a matter of having more STEM, more Lego, more robotics in class, or is it a bigger picture that we're trying to solve?
Yeah, I think that's part of it, but it's definitely more than that. I think it's this is more my personal experience as the mother of three children, and seeing how much STEM they're exposed to in primary school has been fantastic. But the real challenge will be when they're in senior school, when they're looking at the subjects that they're going to study, are they going to continue with maths? Are they going to continue with the more heavy technical subjects? That's probably the point where I think more women are likely to drop out of the talent pool for technology. And so I think schools, yes, they need to be doing the Lego and the coding in primary school, but they also need to be thinking about how they encourage their senior school students, particularly women, to continue on with those STEM subjects.
Well, thank you very much for joining Alexi Boyd and Small Biz Matters. It's great to get some insight from you, and congratulations on the hard work that you're doing with being here representing big business at the Leadership Summit here in Australia.
Thank you.
Thank you. You've been speaking to Alexi Boyd. We're live on the floor of the Leadership Institute Women in Leadership Summit, and it's great to be talking to big business, small business, delegates and sponsors alike.